For more about events in Syria and a possible military response to this week's attack, we're joined now via Skype from Washington, D.C. by Stephen Cook. He's a senior fellow with the Council on Foreign Relations. His specialty is the Middle East. So is a military intervention inevitable?
Well, it seems based on the statements of President Obama, Prime Minister Cameron of Great Britain, the French President Francois Hollande, that the chemical attacks last Wednesday in Syria will not go unpunished. Just what level of military response remains an open question, but it seems inevitable at this point.
So what are some of those consequences that this group of willing nations need to keep in mind?
Well, they need to keep in mind that the Syrians, as well as their primary ally, the Iranians, have the capacity to further destabilize Syria, Iraq, Lebanon, and other parts of the Middle East. It's not as if this military response would not go unanswered by either the Syrians, the Iranians, or the Iranians' proxy, Hezbollah, which is engaged in battle both in Syria as well as increasingly at home in Lebanon.
One of the concerns that people have with any sort of intervention is that, do we know exactly who it is that we're helping? Is there one unified opposition?
No, there isn't one single unified opposition. However, the President of the United States and other Western leaders have said consistently that the use of chemical weapons in Syria is something that the international community could not tolerate. In this case, it seems that the United States and allies would be trying to help the Syrian people rather than one particular group or another within the Syrian rebellion, which is quite divided.
And what about the geopolitical consequences? How are Russia or China or Iran going to take this?
Well, clearly the Iranians are not going to allow the United States and allies to undertake military action without some sort of response somewhere, whether it's in northern Israel, southern Lebanon, Iraq, other places. It's clear that the Iranians have the capability to further destabilize the region. The Russians and the United States are clearly at odds over Syria, and already the Russian Foreign Ministry has cautioned the United States, the British, and the French not to jump to conclusions about who used chemical weapons. They are arguing that it could have been the Syrian rebellion that had used these weapons rather than the regime of Bashar al-Assad.
You know, we've seen reports about people considering the parallels between our intervention in Kosovo, a limited amount of airstrikes over a specific parcel of land, or what we did in Libya. But these aren't parallel cases.
Well, they are very different cases. Each one of these cases present their own set of unique challenges. And the professional military, as well as many defense intellectuals around the country, have pointed out that it is a risky proposition to maintain a no-fly zone over Syria, that it would require much more effort than in Libya, and that there are tremendous risks both to American and allied air crews as well as to Syrian civilians, with no guaranteed payoff in terms of helping to defeat Bashar al-Assad and his forces.
All right. Stephen Cook, thanks so much for your time.
My pleasure.